dy by dx equals 1 plus e to the power minus x, right, times y square minus 1. So now when solving of differential equations, be very careful. Don't expect that every time you are getting dy times a function of y, right, on the numerator side, every time, right? So if you have something like dy times a function of y on the numerator or in upstairs, it will look very nice. But every time, don't expect like that. Sometimes there can be changes. Sometimes you will not get like that. Sometimes you might be getting dy times the function of y at the denominator. But anyhow, doesn't matter. The first target is to get dy times some function of y with the derivative term. That is the target. Okay? Let's see. I will explain you quickly. Right? So no problem. Now, dy times a function of y with the derivative dy. But unfortunately, when you get this y squared minus 1 term to other side, it will not come in the numerator. It will go to the denominator side. Dy divided by y squared minus 1. Okay, doesn't matter. Never mind. Keep it. Put dx to the other side by cross multiplication. Dx times 1 plus e to the power minus x. So that doesn't matter. Because this part, of course, no problem. Because that is easy. Right? Because the reason why I am telling that is easy, you can separate dx times this one, that one. Okay, that doesn't matter. So now let's proceed. Now what you have to do? Integrate both sides. Integrate both sides. Okay? Right. That means integrate this side with respect to y, integrate this side with respect to x. Integration 1 over y square minus 1 dy equals integration of dx times 1 plus e to the power minus x. This side you can nicely separate, right? Integration of dx, because you have nothing there. Nothing means actually you have x to the power 0. It doesn't matter. Plus here, integration of e to the power minus x dx. This is also easy, but you have to do a little change. Integration 1 over y square minus 1 dy. So if you are looking at this problem, at the very first sight, you will see that this looks a bit hard to solve, but it is not hard. You have to do some little changes. You have to use your primary knowledge. That means, you know, what is integration? Integration is the reverse process of differentiation. So that means you need to find, after differentiating, what kind of a thing you are getting this. Right? So that kind of thing is the answer for that. Now, we have a solution for that. You can use the knowledge of partial fractions. Partial fractions, okay? Right. So what can you do? 1 over y square minus 1. You can do, you can separate what you call the factors. So 1 over y squared minus 1 means 1 over a difference of two squares, right? Y squared minus 1, y minus 1 times y plus 1, right? Y minus 1 times y plus 1, this is plus. So you can adopt simple partial fraction rule. Let's say that is identically same as a divided by y minus 1 plus b divided by y plus 1. So now you can find the what are the coefficients. So that is easy, it's not hard. So 1 identically equals a times y plus 1 plus b times y minus 1. So 1 identically equals, let's consider the terms of coefficient of y, ay, by. So you are getting a plus b. Let's consider the constant term. You are getting a here, b here, so a minus b. So that is no problem by equating the constant term, because 1 is the only constant term that you have there. So 1 equals a minus b. because here the only constant term that appears is a minus b. So 1, let's say 1 equals a minus b, because here 1 is the only constant term. Here only a minus b is the term that looks like the constant. And when considering the coefficient of y, here there is no any y term. So coefficient of y from that side is 0 equals, here we have some, you know, virtual coefficient for y, so that is a plus b. A plus b equals 0, a minus b equals 1. So what is the answer? It's very easy at both the equations. So you are getting 1 equals 2a, so a is half, right? So if a is half, what must be b? So let's consider a plus b equals 0. So that means definitely b must be minus half, right? Got it? Okay. Right, because our problem is not to solve partial fractions. It's not about partial fractioning. Okay, right. So now, shall I rewrite the problem? This part I will erase, okay? Because I need to save some space. Right, you can go back to the video. Right. So what you got previously? Integration, I will write the same thing again, integration 1 over y square minus 1 times dy equals here integration of x to the power 0 dx plus integration e to the power minus x dx, right? And this part you can write now because you have already obtained what are the partial fractions of that. So this term you can write like half times 1 over y minus 1, because this half is the coefficient a plus, okay, I will put some bracket, plus minus half times 1 over y plus 1, right? How to do that? Okay, let's put another larger bracket, right? Because I'm writing the same thing times dy. Okay, after solving the partial fractions, you can open like that. Equals here, it's never mind, x to the power 0 is 1, so no problem. So that means what is the answer there? Integration of x to the power 0, x to the power 0 plus 1. That means the answer is x to this side. Integration of this is x. What is the integration of that? That means you have to see what, after differentiating, what you are getting some term like that. So let's consider e to the power minus x. So if you differentiate e to the power minus x, you are getting e to the power minus x times minus 1. But unfortunately that minus 1 part is not there. So what you can do is, you can introduce minus 1 to there. Right? No problem. Just introduce some minus 1 to there. Otherwise it will not look nice. See, if you introduce such a new term, you have to do the same thing to other side. Okay? So either you can say 1 over minus 1. Right? Because this 1 to 1 will cancel, but doesn't matter, no problem. Or else you can just keep minus 1, right? No problem, because you have to balance the original function. Or else you can take minus 1 as a factor. If you take minus 1 as a factor, here it will result another minus 1. Okay, so what is the answer for this one then? That means we have already adjusted this, right? You have taken minus 1 as a factor times integration of this. Okay, I will write it again. Here the integration is no problem, right? The answer is x plus minus as a factor integration of e to the power minus x times minus 1 dx. Okay, right. It's not hard, not hard, easy. So this part also let's write separately. integration dy times integral of this integration half 1 over y minus 1 dy plus integration minus half 1 over y plus 1 dy equals x plus now plus minus we can now see here we have plus you have minus you can do multiplication and you can put minus directly x minus integration of e to the power of minus x minus 1 dx. So what is the answer for this one? Here you can take half 1. So after differentiating, what sort of a thing you are getting? 1 over y minus 1. So now just recall, you know, logarithmic type differentiation. So if you have something called ln y minus 1, let's say that you have something called ln y minus 1. So if you differentiate this with respect to y, okay, you are getting 1 over the same thing that has appeared there. And the differentiation, a further differentiation of this. So what is the further differentiation of this with respect to y? It's 1. Right? So, is that clear? If you have something called ln y minus 1, if you are going to differentiate this with respect to y, because this y term is not familiar to you, right? Okay, then I will do something like this. Because x is the term where you are mostly familiar with. Okay, so let's say that you have something called ln x minus 1. Now, okay, no? So now let's say you are going to differentiate this. Differentiate this with respect to x. Right? Ln x minus 1, you can differentiate with respect to x. What is the answer? 1 over the same thing that has appeared inside this logarithmic brackets, right? Inside this part. So 1 over x minus 1 and the differentiation of this part. What is the differentiation of this part? X minus 1 is, that is 1. So now I hope you got it. So what is the answer for this one? If you differentiate, half times ln y minus 1. Easy, right? Here, what would be the answer for this one? The minus half you can take out, right? Answer would be ln y plus 1, right? Equals x minus, if you get the integral of this one, so it would be e to the power minus x plus the total constant. That k is the arbitrary constant. Here also you can do some further simplification. You can take this half out because that is common. Ln this minus this part. So that is also easy. There also there's a shortcut. That means now if you take half out, what you have is this ln y minus 1 minus ln y plus 1. This also you can write because there is a shortcut. Difference of logarithmic parts will be same as the division of this divided by that, because like the minus part should go to the denominator, right? If you have something like this, just take this into your mind. If you have something like this, you can write like this. Okay, got it? Clear? Equals x minus e to the power minus x plus k. You don't need extra brackets, right? So you can put half times ln within brackets y minus 1 divided by y plus 1 equals x minus e to the power minus x plus k.